morning. The time is 8:07. Currently a few clouds moving into north central Wisconsin at our Bowfall studios on the corner of Washington Street and North 3rd Street. Currently 55 degrees. Again, it was a little bit brighter, a little bit earlier as I was coming into work, but these clouds are moving in. Could there be some rain? Well, there might be, and we'll find out exactly what we can expect weather-wise later on here with Brittney Merlot at 8:20. But first, let me say good morning and welcome to the Tuesday edition of the Chad Holmes Show on Bowfalls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bowfallsradio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app. Again, you can also join us by going to our Facebook page or our X page, facebook.com, x.com, and search out Bowfalls Radio, and then you can tune into our video stream as well. You can make comments there. We will share those comments with others as well here on the program. And you can also join us by either giving us a call or giving us a text. The easy way is to just bring up the Civic Media app, and then there's a button that will say call. There's a button that will say text, and you just click on that, and you'll be able to hook up with the show real, real simply. And you can also dial us up at 715-382-9297. That's 715-382-9297 to join us here for the next 2 hours on Bowfalls Radio. Coming up in the second hour of the program, it'll be another opportunity to win with the Civic Media Scani Summer Text to Win Contest. Day number 7 of 10 when it comes to our Scani Summer Contest. And boy, the response has been terrific. It really has been. I think we're very happy to see a lot of people reaching out to win a number of different prizes. In fact, you can win 3 different prizes. We have an hourly prize. Every hour that we play the contest, which is 7 times a day, have a chance to win a Wisconsin Dells Summer Prize Pack. Everybody that texts in during the hour is part of that drawing. And then everybody that texts in during the course of the entire day, part of a daily prize, which is a pair of Milwaukee Brewer Club level seats. And then everybody that texts in during the entirety of the contest, a chance to win the grand prize, a choice of a unique summer staycation getaway, complete with gas to get you there and back, including the Fort Atkinson Cottage on the lake, including a pontoon boat, Lake Geneva stay at Harbor Shores, Door County stay at the Ridges Inn and Suites. So again, just great prizes. We're going to be doing it for the rest of this week. And coming up in hour number 2 of the program, I will give you our keyword for the hour. And then all you have to do is bring up the Civic Media app and text us that keyword. Just one word, real simple, and then you're part of the drawings, all the drawings. And again, if you listen throughout the course of the day here on Bowfalls Radio, the contest is run every other hour, starting at 7 o'clock in the morning with Up North News. Here in the 9 o'clock hour on this program, 11 o'clock hour during Matinair on Air, during the 1 o'clock hour with the Todd Alba Show, during the 3 o'clock hour with Maggie Dawn, 5 o'clock hour, the Devil's Advocates, and then Nightlight with Pete Schwabba at 7 o'clock as well. So all these great opportunities to win, and the more that you send in those texts, if you send them in during every show, that's 7 different opportunities to win hourly prizes. That gives you more chances to win the daily prize. And then if you do it every day during the course of this contest, that means 7 times 10 days, 70 opportunities to be part of that grand prize drawing to win that unique summer staycation getaway package courtesy of Civic Media and Bowfalls Radio. So that's coming up in hour number 2 of the program. Also today on the show, in the second hour, we'll be joined by Ann Stevening Rowe, and we're going to talk about fair maps. And recently, we had Hans Breitenmoser on talking about this, and Hans and Ann, both part of a group that's been really on the forefront of being able to push forward and try to, number one, make the changes to the maps. And now that changes have been made, what does it mean? What can we expect? What kind of excitement is there? Are we getting better candidates? A lot to talk about in terms of fair maps with Ann Stevening Rowe coming up at 9:35 this morning here on the program. Also, I had been promoting on my social media that also this morning we would be joined by Tristan Wickland from Mosinee High School. Just an outstanding student athlete, just graduated from Mosinee, just finished up a trip to the state softball tournament. She was also a captain and a state championship winner with the Central Wisconsin Storm during the winter. And then during the fall, she was the player of the year in the Great Northern Conference in high school volleyball. And we had set up to have Tristan join us in the first hour of the program, but just feeling a little bit under the weather. Not really surprised. I've noticed that when you go through a process and you go through a grind, and it's been a long grind, both with the school year, with all these sports, sometimes it's all, when you get done with it, which happened for Tristan on Saturday, sometimes it just happens where, oh, the body says, okay, we need a break. And she was just feeling a little bit under the weather. So we're going to reschedule Tristan Wickland, hopefully, perhaps on Friday, have her come in and join us here on the program. So again, I just wanted to mention that for those of you who were checking out my social media, which I don't know if you're not, follow me on Facebook. You can follow me on Threads, on Instagram, and on X. And I put on the social media platforms what we can expect on our shows each and every day. So again, if you are following me on any of those social media platforms, please do so. And you can stay up to date on our guests and the topics that we have here on Bow Falls Radio and on this program as well. So that's coming up. So Ann Stevening Rowe will be our guest coming up at 9:35 this morning here on the show. And then again, Tristan Wickland, hopefully on Friday. Before we move any further, need to say hello and good morning to our in-studio engineer and producer, Ian Welsh. Ian, good morning.
Good morning, Chuck.
I was, you know, when I got the message this morning from Tristan that I was just feeling a little bit, wanted to not take any chances. She's actually going to be following now some of her classmates on the Mosinee baseball team to the state tournament for their semifinal tomorrow. I wanted to make sure she's okay for that, and then hopefully the state championship game as well on Thursday. But I've found in the past that sometimes when you go through something where you're putting a lot into it, when it comes to an end, sometimes it's like, okay, the body says it's okay to actually feel lousy for a day or two. I know that you go through all this with the shows. I mean, you don't want to get sick during the show. It's almost as though you can will your way through it. And I know that sometimes during the course of a rehearsal run and then a run of shows as well, you just have to, you know, grit the teeth and get through it. And then after it's done, it's almost as though the body says, okay, I need a break. Do you ever get that way where it's like after a show, the body just sort of shuts down for a day or two and says, okay, give me a break?
Absolutely. And sometimes you do get sick during the rehearsal process as well, but it's better to get sick early on in the process than actually be sick on tech week. So at least if you get sick a little earlier, you have a chance to heal up and get better. But yeah, usually after, like, especially after you do like 2 weekends of shows, it takes a toll on the body. I'm definitely feeling a little bit of that.
And it's not just a physical thing, I would think it would be, the stress mentally, aspect. Yeah, I mean,
mentally and emotionally, it can kind of take a lot out of you. Your energy levels go down, muscles are sore, your throat can be a little raw sometimes. So it's always good to take a couple of days off after theater, or in my case, a couple of weeks, because I need to make sure I heal properly. But, you know, just rest often, drink plenty of water. Tea is always a good thing. A spoonful of honey right before bedtime, it really helps the throat. Just simple remedies, especially good for during shows, and especially good after shows too. So
right.
Yeah, it's definitely it takes a toll on the body, but thankfully it's not permanent.
Also, I think the mental aspect too. I just find that you have to have a focus. You have to be able to focus, and there's a stress aspect that's also, I think, above the neck, where it's like, you know, between the focus and then the stress, because there's a pressure involved in it. So both physically and mentally. And the thing about it as well is that when you're involved in something like that, I think it really does make you a stronger person, because you have to go through absolutely. This, and you have to perform. You have people that count on you. So again, I think that's another reason why to be involved, whether, you know, talking about someone like Tristan Wicklund, who's involved in athletics, and, mm-hmm. and yourself and others who are involved in the performing arts. I just think that being involved in these different kind of activities does add another layer to us as human beings in terms of being able to accomplish things. And I think it adds to a success in other areas of your life as well, that if you're involved in these kind of activities, then being able to succeed in these activities, or even at times maybe, you know, come up short, but then learn lessons from it, it can really add to the success in many different aspects of one's life.
It really does, actually. I mean, the theater is all about, you know, trying different things, and yeah, you're going to make a lot of mistakes. That's all part of the learning process. That's how you grow and become better. I mean, if you don't make mistakes, how are you going to learn anything?
Exactly. So again, we'll get Tristan Wicklund back with us hopefully on Friday to talk about what's been just a fantastically successful mm-hmm. senior year with her athletics. And she'll actually be continuing with her athletics at the next level at St. Norbert College on the hockey rink coming up next year. So again, it's a little bit interesting and a little melancholy, because I follow these athletes so closely over the years, and now at this time of year you see a number of them graduating, but very fortunate to see some of them actually being able to continue at the college level as well. Again, a very pleasant start here in North Central Wisconsin. We're going to talk about the weather coming up with Brittney Merlot in just a few moments. And also coming up in this hour, we're going to talk about the results of that Wausau School Board survey on a potential referendum. And I think that we have a referendum, a survey set of results that people can use in different ways. And I'm going to kind of explain that a little bit later on in the hour as well. With Ian Welsh, I'm Chad Holmes. It is the Chad Holmes Show. Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230.
Is.
And welcome back. Chad Holmes with you here on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. And again, also, again, don't forget, you can make it into a mini TV show by going to facebook.com and x.com, go to the Bull Falls Radio page, and then watch our video stream, make your comments about the show, and also, again, join us by either calling or texting us. Again, if you'd like to call or text, again, go to the Civic Media app, but also you can just call us up or text us at 715-382-9297. That's 715-382-9297 to join us and be part of the program as well. But right now, as we do at 8:20 every weekday morning, very happy to welcome back to the program a person that wears many hats, our meteorologist, also our news reporter, Brittney Merlot. And Brittney, good morning.
Good morning, Chad. How are you?
Doing terrific. Before we talk about the weather, I wanted to give another shout out to what you're doing on the news side as well, because you do have a couple of different ways to keep up to what's going on here in Central Wisconsin. If you go to our website, you have basically a news podcast, and also you have a newsletter as well. Could you again let the folks know what they're getting if they're able to go to bullfallsradio.com and either tune into the podcast or sign up for the newsletter?
Yeah, absolutely. So the podcast, I think, is super awesome. It's very easy. It's about, 5 minutes long, and you're going to get the entire news for the entire day. You're going to get some state stuff, my local stuff, and it only take about 5 to 10 minutes of your day up, and you'll be caught up to speed with everything. So that's a quick listen on your drive to work, or if you're picking up the kids from school. Otherwise, if you like to read, that newsletter is pretty cool as well. So throughout the week, I'll take and write a bunch of news articles on what's going on here locally or even throughout the state. I do a lot of environmental and weather stories as well. But you can get that emailed to you every Thursday. You just go ahead to our website, bullfallsradio.com. You'll see that sign up right there. It kind of pops into your face. But, you know, just go ahead and do that, and I'll send that to you every single week. And if you have news stories or ideas or concerns about what's going on in our area, you can actually respond to that email and I'll get it. So it's the direct contact to your local reporter, which is pretty cool. You know, you can't really get a hold of the TV reporters. Those are hard to find sometimes. So
no layers between you and your adoring public, right?
Exactly.
But no, I would emphasize again what Brittney just said. Again, really good stuff in a very digestible form that allows you to continue to do whatever you're doing and also make sure you're up to speed on what's going on around here, especially in central Wisconsin. So again, go to bullfallsradio.com. You can, again, listen to the podcast and sign up for the newsletter as well. Well,
this even the app, too. I want to say, too, Chad, with this weekend coming up, we're having a lot of active, crazy weather, and people like to travel in the summer. You're not always going to stay right here at home with the stations that you're used to, but if you download that Civic Media app and you're traveling around, it's going to give you weather updates for wherever you are, so which is super awesome and amazing if you're out on the road. So keep that in mind, too.
Absolutely. You're exactly right. There are such a great list of reasons to get that app, and it really is. Yes. It's really a cool app. They really worked hard. It's the sound quality when you listen is fantastic, and then again, to be able to contact us and contact our website, I mean, it's all right there. So again, download that app, and also again, to win, as we'll do in the next hour with our Scotty Summer Text to Win contest as well.
And it blows my mind too that we can text, we can hop on Facebook and chat in this podcast, and you can get everyone's feedback and information. I used to be scared to call, you know, back in the day. So it's interesting now that all you have to do is text and we can say whatever we want to you, Chad.
Well, that's a good point right there. Hey, this morning when I first came in, there was some sunshine, and I know there's a little bit more cloud cover than we saw yesterday, but as we've been going into the morning, I've noticed that the clouds have started to thicken up a little bit. Right now, it looks fairly overcast here in downtown Wausau, and that's kind of a preview of where we're headed for the rest of the day, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Clouds are building and rolling in from the west, and it's already raining into portions of Eau Claire and Cumberland and northwest Wisconsin. So what's happening is I always like to sweeten the deal. Yes, we're getting light rain this afternoon. Yes, it's going to be cloudy, and it's still cool today with highs in the upper 60s. So here's the positives of this. We have to go through this in order to get some low to mid 80s tomorrow, because a warm front is the reason why this rain is even firing up and moving here. So as we welcome the warm front, yes, we'll get some light rain this afternoon, but the heat is on tomorrow. Low to mid 80s, abundant sunshine out there. It's going to be feeling like summer.
Actually, this morning as I was getting ready as well, on the Civic Media statewide newscast very early this morning, one of the stories was that we can expect in the state of Wisconsin warmer than normal temperatures for the next couple of months. Is that what you're seeing as well?
You know, I am, but that's kind of been the trend I feel the past few years. You know, we kind of keep beating and beating and slowly warming more than the year prior. So that doesn't shock me at all, unfortunately.
So make sure those air conditioners are ready as we get to the midst of summer.
Yes. And I don't know about you, but the longer days, have you noticed that the light last night, it threw me off. I went to bed way too late because it was 9 o'clock before the last light was even gone. Our sunrise is at 5:11 now, and our sunsets are at 8:45. We are only 3 minutes away from the longest day of the year, which of course is coming up June 20th, the first day of summer. That's next Thursday. So we're already pretty much seeing our maximum amount of sunlight for the year. Isn't that cool?
And then, of course, things start to get short, which is amazing when you get to, you know, June the 20th or whatever it may be. And all of a sudden, you know, yeah, we get on that slide that goes slowly down for 6 months. I mean, yeah. It's really something. I mean, it doesn't feel like that way. It still feels so early in the year to me, but things just go by so very quickly. All right, sure, Brittney, what are the details here for today, maybe tomorrow as well?
Absolutely. So getting cloudy by this afternoon. Some light showers are possible, mainly from about 12 to 5 throughout Wausau area. That'll actually clear on out. We might see some pockets of sun before sunset. It's going to get breezy this evening with winds out of the south warming us up because that warm front will be here. Tomorrow, starting off, mostly sunny, highs climbing to the low 80s. But by night, we are in a slight risk for strong to severe thunderstorms to fire up. This is going to be a Wednesday night to Thursday morning event, and some of these could definitely be severe. So we're going to have to keep an eye on that one. As that passes behind it, though, Thursday, we will still be in the 80s, sunny, breezy, and in fact, it just keeps getting warmer and more humid as we push into the weekend with even more storm activity as well. So we're really getting into the swing of severe season now.
Okay, Brittney. Well, thanks again for all that information. A reminder, everybody, go to the site, sign up for Brittney's great information with the podcast and the newsletter, and we'll talk to you again tomorrow.
Sounds good. Have a great one. Bye.
Bye, Brittney.
That's our Brittney Merlot again joins us every weekday at 8:20 here on the program. Right now, fair skies, 55 degrees, southeast winds at 8 miles per hour. The dew point is 40, relative humidity of 57%. The barometer at 29.97 inches and a visibility of 10 miles. An information update coming up, news, weather, and sports. And then we'll come back and talk about that Wausau School Board survey. Got some information about a potential referendum. We'll talk about that coming up as well. With Ian Welsh, I'm Chad Holmes, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230.
Champions are crowned in softball and lacrosse, including a record win streak coming to an end. I'm Travis Wilson, and this is a WISSports.net Minute brought to you by Wisconsin Dells, the water park capital of the world.
Wondering what makes Wisconsin Dells the perfect summer getaway? Let's find out. Let's splash. Let's play. Let's try something completely new. Let's make sure we do this again next year. Hey, I'm working up an appetite. Let's eat. Need a guys' weekend? Let's do guy stuff. Need a girls' weekend? Let's go, girls. Need a family getaway? Let's have some together time. Wisconsin Dells, let's make this the best vacation ever. Go to wisdells.com and start planning your trip to the water park capital of the world today.
It was a busy weekend of state tournaments, including the first ever WIAA Boys and Girls Lacrosse Championships. After taking down undefeated and top-ranked Wanakee in sectional play, the Middleton Boys Lacrosse Squad kept things going on Saturday, scoring twice in the final 2 minutes to secure a 7-6 win over Nina. The Girls Championship game was a close one as well, with the Kettamoraine Badger Co-op hanging on for an exciting 17-15 victory against University School. One of the big stories heading into the 48th WIAA Softball State Tournament was the Kaukauna Galloping Ghosts and their lengthy winning streak. However, that came to an end in the D1 State Semifinals when Milton took down Kaukauna 5-3, ending a 108-game winning streak. Milton didn't quite have enough left in the tank in the final, however, as Kenosha Bradford scored its first title with a 9-3 victory. It was a first in Division II as well, where Waupun took down Mozanese 7-3 for the championship. The string of firsts continued in the next two divisions as well, as Prescott captured the D3 crown by defeating Laconia, and Fall Creek shut out Cuba City for the Division IV title. In a rematch of last season's Division V state title game, Pacelli rallied for 3 runs in the fifth and scored a second consecutive championship 4-3 over Oakfield. This has been a WISSports.net Minute. Check us out online at WISSports.net.
Another tricky decision for the Wausau School Board as we continue here on this Tuesday morning. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. 8:37 is the time. Again, clouds are moving in, temperature at 55 degrees. Again, you can join us, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230 on the radio, bowfallsradio.com if you're at your computer. Mobile devices by searching WXCO. You can use Alexa to say search out Bow Falls Radio or WXCO. Go to the Civic Media app as well. And again, make sure you have that app downloaded, because coming up after 9 o'clock, we'll give you another opportunity to win with the Civic Media Scani Summer Text to Win Contest. Also, again, join us on Facebook.com and X.com on the Bow Falls Radio page. You can watch us on the stream and join us with comments there as well. Because coming up now, I would love to hear some comments from the community concerning the Wausau School District and the decision they have to make when it comes to a potential referendum. Again, you can join us by calling or texting us, 715-382-9297. That's 715-382-9297 to give your thoughts as we go through another weekday morning here on Bow Falls Radio. But we have now found some results from the month-long survey that was done by the Wausau School District concerning a potential operational referendum. Again, this is about operational costs. The district faces a significant budget shortfall, and they are trying to decide what direction they would like to go in. And one of the obvious choices is potentially to go to the voters on a referendum to try and get some money to cover those costs. And nearly 2,000 people participated in the month-long survey conducted by the Donovan Group. Participants were asked about their overall satisfaction with the district, as well as their thoughts on various hypothetical referendum questions and scenarios. And there's something, you know, and I've mentioned this from time to time, and maybe you've noticed it as well. On many programs, including right here on Civic Media, during many newscasts, whether it's a national newscast or a statewide newscast or even local newscast, from time to time you'll hear results of polls, especially when it comes to the presidential race, sometimes maybe the Senate race between Tammy Baldwin and Eric Hovde. And I have said I am not going to fall into that rabbit hole. I am not going to be one of these people that is constantly spending time talking about the results of polls, because, again, you can take some numbers and use them in many different ways, both accurately and inaccurately. And when it comes to these numbers, when it comes to the numbers of these nearly 2,000 people that filled out this survey in the Wausau School District, you can, I would say, skew these numbers in different ways. Because when I looked at it, you could say, hey, there is a path forward to a majority to have a referendum and have it be passed in November. But also you can look at these numbers and say, the public right now is not ready for this. And it would be a very uphill climb to get to a majority in a potential referendum. According to the numbers, and according to an analysis on WAOW.com, nearly 60% of the people said they were likely to support an operational referendum on the November 2024 ballot. So you say, you see that, and you say, hey, that's, you know, if you're looking to try to close this budget deficit without having to cut significant staff or other areas or programming or whatever it may be, however you would try to get from a deficit back to a break-even point, hey, that sounds great. You know, nearly 60% saying they're likely to support an operational referendum. But then if you dig a little deeper, those numbers are not quite as bright. According to some different scenarios, 61% of respondents say they would vote yes again on a referendum to increase the revenue limit by $3 million a year while maintaining current staffing levels and current mill rate. Also, an option, 45% of people support a $6 million increase with a tax increase of $54 on each $100,000 of property value. Just 28% of the people supported a $9 million increase with a tax increase of $108 per $100,000. And also, of course, when you talk about those numbers, the property value, we've had recently the city of Wausau re-evaluation of homes when looking at the value of property and homes in our area. So that obviously is a factor as well when you put out questions such as that. And obviously when your house has been reassessed and the value goes up, up, and up, and that leads to higher, you know, tax bills, that is going to affect whether or not perhaps you are willing to vote yes on a referendum that could potentially affect your mill rate in a way that would have you pay more in terms of taxes. According to WAOW in their story, Pat McKee, board member, said if we decide to go forward and ask the question, we need to be crystal clear about what those impacts are to kids, to families, to staff. Because for people to say, well, go fix it internally, that's fine. We can fix it internally, but the next minute it will be felt externally. And that's, I think, a very good point, that the board and the district do have ways of erasing the deficit. And some of those ways could be very painful when it comes to the education of the students of the Wausau School District. So you have to realize that, hey, okay, then, you know, your pocketbook ultimately on the tax rate will not change. But ultimately, if you have schools that are not performing, or if you have schools where people from the outside that are considering moving into the area say, well, there's a lot of issues there. They're not investing in their schools at the same level. They're not going to provide the proper education for my young family. That obviously could have a major trickle-down effect as well. So, again, I mean, there's, when you get into major budget difficulties, there are not easy answers. There never are easy answers. There's going to be pain one way or the other. And frankly, and this is sort of a, I would say, more of a broad-based observation right now. I wonder at this point in our country's history, June the 11th of 2024, as we look right now on the calendar, are we able to, in some ways, what I call the word sacrifice for the better good? Because when I look at the way that this country has fractured in significant ways in the past 10, 20, 30 years, even, you know, even beyond that, are we able to come together when need be, the way that we have over the course of much of the nearly 250 years of American history? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know whether or not we are at this point where there are people that are going to say, I don't care about my neighbor. I don't care about the future of my community or state, because I know that the folks across the street, they have a different campaign sign out on their lawn. So why should I help them? Why should I help somebody that disagrees so fundamentally with what I believe in? And that's, I think, a major issue as we move forward. And again, so often we look back, and I do think that it's important to look back. I think it's important to have a good knowledge of history when it comes to trying to fix problems of the present and problems of the future. But are we able to come together in a way that makes our communities better, and able to come together even with people that you may disagree with in some fundamental ways? And are we able to, in this case, come together to decide, hey, we would rather not have massive cuts to staffing or massive cuts to programs, and perhaps have a little bit of individual pain in order to make sure that we are not having to make those cuts in that way? And that's one of the things that the district is trying to do with this survey. And if the district wants to go to the ballot box in November. Any potential referendum questions need to be drafted and approved by mid-August. So, again, we are... I've said this before. I keep looking for a brake pedal because time is going by so quickly, and mid-August will be here very quickly. So the board will likely have to discuss this in their July meeting, get put on the agenda there as well. So, again, interesting numbers. And, in fact, to be blunt with you, frankly, I think the numbers are more encouraging than I would have expected, because there has been, I think, in recent years, a lot of talk about the trust factor between the district, the board, and the community, that with all the talk about potential consolidation of the high schools and such, talk about the previous referendum and the money that went towards that. But these numbers, I think, in a lot of ways are encouraging. And it's going to be very interesting to see what the next steps are. And in fact, as we come back after a minute, if there are thoughts that you have, are you somebody that is thinking, hey, this is reasonable? I would be reasonable. It would be a reasonable thought to vote yes on a referendum. Or are you saying, with all the issues on the current valuation of property that's led to some pain for many folks, this would not be a good idea? Again, if you are interested in letting your voice be heard, would love to hear it, again, by either commenting on our Facebook page and X page, or by giving us a call as well. So we'll be right back with Ian Welsh. I'm Chad Holmes, Chad Holmes Show, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230.
Hello, Wausau. It's Ryan.
And Paul.
From the Wausau Business Show. We'll see you this Saturday, 8 to 9 a.m. with who, Paul?
This week we have Scott Wimmer on the show. We'll be broadcasting from...
State Park Speedway.
Love it.
Feeling great in 88.
Have a good time.
State Park Speedway. We'll ask him about that jingle for sure.
And we're also going to ask him about what is the future of State Park Speedway.
NASCAR, I'm going to call him a local legend. Yes. NASCAR legend Scott Wimmer joins us this Saturday on the Wausau Business Show.
Stay tuned.
We'll see you Saturday, Wausau.
And welcome back, Chad Holmes Show, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. BullFallsRadio.com. Mobile devices by searching WXCO. Civic Media app. You know the drill, don't you? But I got to keep reminding folks, because hopefully there are people that are joining us as we continue every day. That's the goal. Hopefully there's somebody out there that is new to the program, that has not tuned in, may have found us, you know, searching the dial while driving around and saying, hey, this is worth spending a little time with during the course of my day. And if you are somebody that's new, very happy to have you on board. And if you're out there and you enjoy anything that we're doing here, I would really encourage you to let folks know about it, because obviously, you know, we advertise, but there's no better advertisement than people that say, hey, I like the show, I like what you do, I like to spread the word, and that would be greatly appreciated as well. And we've heard a lot of good things about the Wausau Business Show, and we just heard the promo. And again, the Wausau Business Show, every Saturday morning from 8 till 9 a.m., as they said, Scott Wimmer, great racer from Central Wisconsin, has competed at the very top levels of NASCAR, was a Cup Series driver. Him and the family saved State Park Speedway. It looks as though that's going to be coming to an end, however, after this year. It'll be very interesting to hear what the guys and Scott Wimmer talk about on the weekend. But I gotta ask Ian, I need some advice here, because last week and every week I talk to the guys who I bring in the show and we air it. And I was talking to them and saying, hey, in a couple of weeks, I'm going to be out of town, so we're going to have to do things a little differently during that week. Mm-hmm. And they said, well, what are you doing? And I mentioned the fact that I'm going to be in Las Vegas in 2 weeks. And during that time, every summer I go out there and I play at least one tournament at the World Series of Poker, sometimes maybe a second tournament and some other little things where I play poker. And said, oh, wow, would you come on the show and talk about that? And I thought, oh, I don't know. It's like, I'm not that good. I'm not Scott. I didn't make it all the way to the NASCAR Cup Series or anything like that. So I kind of left it hanging. And that was like on Friday. And then I get a note after the show on Saturday, because they always want to make sure everything goes well. And it goes well. And they always say, thanks for helping out. And then mentioned again, hey, maybe, you know, come on and we can talk about it on the Boss of Business show. And I sort of haven't responded yet. And that's like, I don't know. I do talk from time to time about things that go on, but I don't like to be put in a position to say, hey, this is me and I'm doing all this great stuff, or making a great run. And I mean, yet last year I made a decent run. I made the money and almost had a chance to win the tournament, except for some terrible luck. I don't know if I've talked about it on the show, but we'll maybe do that before I leave in a couple of weeks. But what do you think? Should I say to the guys, okay, I'm willing to come on the Wausau Business Show and talk about my poker exploits, or would that be silly?
Well, I mean, overall, it's your decision, but if you're asking me, I think it'd be okay to share a little bit about it. You don't have to share everything. There's a lot of bad luck you don't have to share. That,
but makes me human if I have bad luck.
That's true, actually. You could share some of that.
I don't know. It's something.
It's your decision, honestly. You don't feel comfortable with it.
I don't know. It's one thing to sit here and to sort of, you know, talk to other folks and talk about issues and talk about that. It's one thing, and then to talk about oneself. And sometimes it's okay, and you like to talk about things that go on, and we've done that. But to say, okay, we're going to talk specifically about you and about what you're doing, I sometimes get a little bit self-conscious about that. So I'm going to probably say, because I want to help out. I want to help those guys out. They do a nice show. They're providing, I think, some good content to our radio station. So if there's something that I can do for them, I think that would be worthwhile. So I think at this point, I may have to send a note to them maybe later today, saying, okay, if you want me on, I will do what you need, and I'll pop on over, and we can talk. So we'll see if I get to that point and get to my phone and say, okay, we're going to do that. So
I mean, personally, I admire your courage to play in a poker tournament in Vegas, because I can never play a poker. I don't have a good poker face. Like, if I have a good hand,
everybody knows it, right?
Smiling. If I have a bad hand, I'll just make like a frown. So I do not have that a straight face.
It's funny, because I had not played for a long time. And a couple of weeks ago, I made a trek over to the Minneapolis area, because that's really the closest place to play in poker tournaments, because I said, I got to practice a little bit. I hadn't played since last summer. So I get there, and I was rusty. But at one point, it's so hard to be calm. You know, I had this one point where I'm just shaking. My hand is shaking, and I haven't heard with. It's like a tell, you know. It's like, and it's like, oh man, I gotta chill out here. I gotta have that poker face. I cannot be showing when I have something good here by shaking when I'm trying to move my chips into the middle here. It's like, oh, but yeah, I'm gonna take it under advisement. So, again, I'm looking forward to that in a couple of weeks, and we'll report on my exploits when I get back here on the program as well. So
hopefully the weather is nice.
It's been nice record high temperatures last week, I saw.
You should bring your sunscreen.
Oh, no kidding. Stay in the air-conditioned comfort of the casinos.
You should have one of those like big umbrellas too.
No kidding. Hey, that's Ian Welsh. I'm Chad Holmes. Coming up, we'll have Anne Stevening Rowe coming up at 9:34 talking about fair maps, but another hour to go here on the program. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230.